Luke and Cassius, IFL TV, we're in Glasgow here, Burns and Crawford, post-fight.
Jibbit, good feet, man.
With me, I've got Ricky Burns. Ricky, on the night, Terence was just too good.
You know, I said before the fight, we knew it was going to be hard. I said the better man would win on the night, so I felt as if it was, I need to go back and watch it, but I thought some of the rounds were close. I knew that obviously because of the judging and that for the last fight, they would go, I think it would have been in his favour. But like I said after the fight, the better man won on the night, but I'd love to get the rematch.
Did you feel at any point in the fight that you hurt Terence?
I think there was one of the rounds I think I hurt him with a body shot, but again he just kept getting back to what he was doing, switching, getting back to, especially when he was southpaw, he was just so awkward. You could hear Billy was telling me during the rounds to start getting second phase punches and that off, but it just, when I was trying to, I just felt as if I was walking onto shots and stuff, so again, he is technically, we knew before the fight how good he was, but when you're in there, he was just so slippery. But like I said, I think there were some things I would do different if the rematch did have to happen. So, but if that's not the case, then there's still some big fights out there for me, so we'll just wait and see what happens.
You haven't suffered a defeat for quite some time now, so what is that feeling like?
Obviously I was gutted today. Obviously getting beat, but like I said, boxing, it's how you come back for it. I've always said boxing, that's all I've been doing for, I've been 12 years old, 18 years now, like I said at the press conference there, I've still got another good 10 years in.
10 years?
There's still some big fights.
Be the B-hop of the Scots world.
like I said, I felt as if it was a good fight. It was, I'll need to go home and watch it obviously, but we'll just need to wait and see what happens next. But anyway, Dehern was saying there is a few different options out there for me, so I'll just leave.
Rematch with Beltran, one of them?
I know he's fighting Roman Martinez, so we'll need to wait and see what happens with that. But like I said, domestically there's some big fights out there for me, and obviously maybe go after one of the other world champions, so we'll just need to wait and see what happens.
Eddie Hearn said that, you know, if you're going to drop back down domestically to fight, then there's got to be some sort of world title, you know, incentive, if you like, in front of you, so you share that view as well?
I'll fight whoever they want me. I know he said take a couple of weeks off and we'll take it from there, but I think I'm going to be going holiday next week. I'll be back, back in the gym, start taking over, but again, I'll fight whoever they want.
Did you all feel alright?
I know the joy's fine. I took a few scalps in the other night, so I can't wait to go home and watch it now, but the joy seems to have held up well, just a wee nick above my eye there. Apart from that, I'm good.
And just finally, just a quick word on the tremendous support that you've always had here.
Some atmosphere out there. The fans are always great up here. Obviously disappointed that I never got the win, but I'm sure that if, as soon as the next fight's announced, fingers crossed they come out and they show their support again. But big thanks to everybody, the fans are unbelievable.
Alright, well listen Ricky, thanks for talking to us. Like I said, it wasn't meant to be for you tonight, but you know, you don't seem that downbeat about it, and you'll pick yourself up and
100%, 100%, aye.
Definitely. All right, Ricky, it's been good spending the week with you, and we'll catch up with you next time we're in Glasgow.
See you in a few weeks.
See you in a few weeks. Coogan Cassius, Ricky Burns, IFL TV, thank you very much.